Oh, it's a wrap. Let me find out. Let me. I would scorch the earth. As fragile as my ego is. And the question this time was, ladies, when did you realize he was wasting your time? And drop his first name and city as well, so we know it's real. In some way, I feel like I'm doing God's work because I'm putting notice for all the other queens out there and all these cities to avoid these kinds of guys. So if anything, you guys are welcome. When did you realize he was wasting your time? When he said it was the right time, but the wrong place. That makes no sense. This is like a guy who watches like one too many rom-coms and is like, yo, in another life, in another time, we could be together. But right now, that's just not it. And he just leaves. That is prime toxic king mentality. Okay, here's how this one knew he was wasting his time. When he would call only to have phone sex and hung up immediately after. This is triggering because I know a lot of people with this name, but luckily I don't know anyone from with this name in this city. His name is Wakas from Philly. The hang up immediately right after is a little weird. Like, stay for the small talk. How was your day? What did you eat? You know, how was work? Did you have anything going on today? Do you wanna maybe make plans later? The hang up afterward is a little weird. but damn, Wakas, get it together. Philly, you're not looking good. When he broke up with me at the airport before boarding a flight that we were taking together. His name is Daniel from, what's KL? I don't know, I'm an immigrant, so I don't know all the 50 states. Kuala Lumpur? What is KL? Somebody Google this, bro. I'm worried. Why would you break up with a girl right before you board a flight that you gotta take together? And if, especially if it's a long flight, damn. Well, we gonna figure out where KL is, but Daniel, no bueno, bro. Left our house because he said he had an emergency. What the fuck on earth is an emergency at 2 a.m. in a tech company? maybe the servers went down. Maybe, right? Servers go down all the time, bro. I see them shaking their heads. Servers go down all the time, miss, okay? And guess what? You know who has to fix them? The brown guys. We gotta go in and do our duty. So if anything, you should be sure that, you know, he's well rested when he gets back from his emergency at 2 a.m. But wait, when he kept ignoring my texts, but would go on other female friends' IGs, calling them hot and sexy. Okay, let's just unpack this, all right? Texting someone requires a different energy than commenting on someone's photos, all right? Like, I cannot respond to your text and still be active on social, and that's okay. Because to me, responding to somebody's text, that's like, all right, now I gotta get in a different headspace. Now I gotta interact. Liking somebody's photo, that's a double tap, move on. That's just efficient, you know? So let's not demonize it. Now, I'm not saying it's okay that he did that. I'm not saying that. But like, I don't wanna hear, oh, you couldn't call me back, but you out here on social media double tapping and liking photos. Like, yes, I am. You're asking me to walk and chew gum at the same time. I can only do one at a time. And guess what? That day I chose to chew gum, all right? So it's totally possible. Yeah, I said it. When he sent me an Excel sheet of our expenses from vacation and included gas. Who does Excel sheets anymore? Bro, just like, first of all, I feel like if you're taking a girl on vacay as a man, like, it's on you, bro. And furthermore, who uses Excel anymore? The fuck is this? Like 1998, we all have iPhones. Just jot the shit down and split it on some app, bro. This to me reeks of like big boomer energy. When he said he realized dating was haram after 3 months into the relationship. Bro, you gotta love Muslim men, bro. Like, we are doing our best. We're doing our best. We're trying, man. We're trying to assimilate while still holding true to our beliefs. And sometimes that goes back and forth. You know, like, you look good and the chemistry's there. So like, for 3 months we're in it. But then Ramadan comes around and you're like, oh, just kidding, it's haram. We're trying our best. Leave us alone, okay? We're doing the best we can. Here's a real one. How did you know he was wasting your time? His ex called him while we were at dinner, and her name popped up with a heart emoji. Called him out on his shit, and now he's marrying said ex, even though she knows he cheated. Look, I think if there's one thing we can take away from all of this, is don't save your jump offs under telling names, right? Save them under Pizza Hut. Save them under settings. Don't put a heart emoji next to your jump off. You're just setting yourself up for failure, Kings. Come on. As for you, my queen, I am so glad that you found this out because you dodged a bullet. I mean, if any man is weak enough to do that, doesn't deserve you. Good for you. When he said, "I don't know what you think this is, but I only hit you up when I'm horny." His name and city: Ethisham from Queens, New York. No, Queens. Hey, look, I think Queens, New York is the capital of toxic men. Like that's where all the toxic men, we have our toxic men conference in Queens, New York, and like 80% of them are Muslims. This does not surprise me. I mean, I feel bad. On one end though, you gotta appreciate he's not lying to you, right? He went into this honest and he's coming out of it just as honest. And I think we can all appreciate that. So good for you, King. Keep it up. Imagine watching this with like your significant other and your name actually pops up and you're like from the city. How uncomfortable would that be, bro? Let there be a video with my name on it and some dirt attached to it. I would be out of the house.